Welcome again in a new video with the secret of Musandam Seas. This is Khasab Port, or this also called the Dabdaba Port. Today our trip going to be to Strait of Hormuz. There are three islands there. They called Salama Island, or in Arabic they call it Ubbat Salama, which is mean the deep blue of Salama. And we are going to Strait of Hormuz. We'll see you there on the sea. Thank you for watching.
The Salama Island and the daughters located in the middle of the Strait of Hormuz.
Reach the Strait of Hormuz. Now these three islands they call Salama Island, and I'll explain the names within my knowledge. And this is the Strait of Hormuz, of course, and this one is called the Big, and the second one, which is behind me, is called the Middle one, and the last one, the end there, it's called the Small one. And this is Salama and the daughters.
Salama is the mother, and Al-Wusta, which is Finako, and Tadmor is the small one. Meaning of Salama is safe or peace. It's a peaceful place. When the wind, the season wind blow, the ship can hide in Salama from the wind until the wind calm down. From July to September, there is easterly and southeasterly wind called Al-Kaws, and the yellow circle where the ship can hide from the wind. November to March is north-northeasterly wind, and the ship can hide to the east. The middle island, or Wusta, also called Finako or Finko or Fanko. And this name came from a company located in Bahrain, and this company put a beacon light over the land for the ship to navigate at night without crashing on the islands. We started the first dive to the west of the Badr of Salama, and the visibility was not surprising. It's good as an open water sea dive, and was like great visibility in this place. Very nice, healthy, colorful coral reef with a lot of colorful fish also. It was amazing dive. Giant barracuda following us along the dive. Cowtail stingray was feeding off the sand. At the end of the first dive, we pass nice, colorful, natural sponge garden with a lot of small, colorful fish.
We did the first dive in that island, the big island Salama, and now we are resting in the second daughter, which is the Al Wusta, so the middle one. And the visibility was great, and this one is the middle island. And if you look at the water, you see how clear is the water. The visibility is really good. And now we are having a break, short break between the two dives, and here is the special Arabic sitting area, and we have a breakfast. This place used to be the most dangerous place when people actually sail through trading from the Gulf countries in the previous, before, from the Arabian Peninsula, and they used to travel through this Strait of Hormuz. And this used to be the most dangerous place because of the sea current. As the tide come in, it's like the neck of a bottle. The tide come into the Gulf and make strong current. And when the tide go down, also make very strong current. Plus also this area is always almost windy. Always, most of the time, it's very windy. So the currents come and the wind come, it make big wave. And it make like a funny current, it's like a circling current. And the name of Musandam, I ask one of the local here, his name Abu Marzouk, or they call him Abu Marzouk. And I ask him why it's called Musandam. And he explained to me, this is actually, there are two words, it's in Arabic. It is the Musan, which is mean the sharpener, and Dam, Musan, Dam. Which is mean the sharpener of the blood. Dam is blood, so it's like the sharpener of blood, or the sharpening blood, which is, and that's because when they sail with this bad current and wind, actually they many ship or many dhows they sank in here, and they lost many people. That's why they call it Musan Dam. That's the name where it came from. And now we are having the rest, and we are diving on the middle islands, the Wusta, and maybe we'll talk after the dive, and then we'll make the third dive as the last dive of the day. Thank you for listening.
You can tell how clean the water is and how good is the visibility. Starting the second dive in the middle island, Al Wusta. To start the dive, we've seen a lot of colorful soft corals, and a very interesting dive. Found something to eat, and as the Remora is escorting her, he trying to share the food with her. Then the fight start between them. Also, the batfish found like a cave or a nice shade to hide on. There's always a chance to see the crayfish or the lobsters on the holes and between the cracks in Salama Islands. The wind started to pick up, then we canceled the third dive and we went back to Khasa.
Thank you for your time and watching the video. Of course, we like good visibility, nice coral reef, but I have some advice. I don't think people misjudge and go to Salama without having the right calculation, because it's Strait of Hormuz. The current unpredictables can be dangerous and people or divers can get lost on that place. So I will not dive on that place on October or on May. These 2 months I will avoid diving on Salama. Also, I will not dive when there is full moon or zero moon because of the tide. We have a high tide and low tide in this time, so make sure the sea is calm when you get there, so the boat captain will not miss the bubbles, because as I see it can be strong current. The other things, between the tide you can have like good 45 to 50 minutes, like when it's the high tide or the lowest tide. Other things, if you go there, have fun and have a nice dive. And thank you for watching the video once again. If you like it, give a thumb up, subscribe if you are not subscribed, and share it so more people will know about Strait of Hormuz. And as always, I recommend people not to keep rubbish or throw any garbage in the ocean. Thank you once again. I'll see you in the next video.